chaos.
Yeah.
Sachinandan Jaya Gora Hari Jaya Sachinandan Jaya Gora Hari
Jaya Gurudeva Jaya Gurudeva Jaya Gurudeva
Jaya Gurudeva Jaya Gurudeva Prabhupada Jaya Prabhupada
अंदर में बैठ बात
बाहर बच्चों के साथ बैठने का अंदर शोर है।
can't touch
Hari
them.
Bol, Hare Krishna. First I am offering my unlimited obeisances to my spiritual master, Nithilila Prabhishnam Vishnam Padai Stotra Sri 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 Madhavati Sri Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. After same obeisances to offering my Sikhya Gurudev, Sri Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Vedanta Goswami Maharaj, Sri Gaur Govind Maharaj, all Vaishnav and all Vaishnav. Kal hum log ne shravan kiya tha श्री विश्वनाथ गुरु ठाकुर कहते हैं जो भक्ति वो स्वतंत्र है, भक्ति ये स्वतंत्रता है और ये भक्ति किसी को अपेक्षा नहीं करती है, अपने आप भक्ति स्वयं पूर्ण है। लेकिन अगर हमारे अंदर में सारे गुण है, अगर भक्ति नहीं कभी, जैसे एक एक प्राणहीन शरीर में जैसे वस्त्र पर उसमें श्रृंगार करने पर जैसे किसी महत्व नहीं, ऐसे ही भगवत भक्ति नहीं तो तुम्हारे कुछ नहीं।
So, yesterday we were hearing Srila Vishnu Thakur describing our bhakti that it is supremely independent. It is completely independent. It does not depend on anybody, it doesn't depend on anything. Whatever results it gives independently. It doesn't have to depend on something else to give its results. And also, we understand that it is like this, that it is if you don't have bhakti in you, but you have so many other qualities, it is you can compare it to a dead body which is being decorated, but because the dead body is lifeless and you decorate it, you can make it wear very nice clothes, you can make it very nice jewelry, but what is the value of all this? Similarly, if you have many, many qualities but you don't have a quality, all these good qualities are yours for Jesus.
If you have no any quality, but only one quality you are bhakti, you know, then easily all good quality came to you. And if you have so many quality, but if you have no bhakti, but this all quality become useless. You know, Ravan, he has so many quality. He know all Ved, Quran, everything he can know. But he have no only bhakti to only Bhagavan Ram. He have no bhakti to Ram. Then everything became useless. Useless. Sri Rupa Goswami, he gave example. Sri Rupa Goswami कहते जैसे एक रानी जाती है. जब एक रानी जाती है ना, देखना उनका जितने सब साथ चली, उसको साथ 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 जाती है, तब जो भक्ति है वो एक रानी है। जब भक्ति चलती है और जितने सारे सद्गुण हैं सब के सब तुम्हारे पीछे पीछे और अपने आप तुम्हारे पीछे पीछे चले।
So Vishwanath Thakur is further describing that bhakti is like a queen. When a queen walks, she is accompanied by her servants, maidservants who are following with folded hands to serve however way, whatever way they can serve her. Similarly, when bhakti walks, when the bhakti is moving, then all the qualities, all the other qualities, etc., they collect together and they stay with bhakti. Wherever bhakti is present, all these qualities automatically manifest there.
So, yeah, because Bhagavan ki naam bhi vaise hai. Lord's name also like this. Kehte Bhagavan ki naam karne ke liye koi kehte na desa niyamat tasmi na kaal niyamat tatha no chishtado nisethasmi Sri Harir namani lukthakam. Yahan par udaharan dete hain Bhagavan ki naam bhi theek vaise hai. Kehte Bhagavan ki naam ko jab karne ke liye bhi koi desh niyam hai, koi kaal ki, कोई किसी चीज की, आप हाथ झूठे हाथ हैं, अच्छे हाथ हो, किसी स्थिति में भी आप भगवान के नाम को जप कर सकते हैं।
So, Rukshan
Bhagavan. नहीं, देखिए, तो पुराण का श्लोक
है। This is a shloka from Quran which is describing that bhakti is independent, it is so independent that to perform bhakti there is no consideration of time, place or circumstances of purity. Even if your hands are impure, you can still chant. Even if you are in pure state yourself, you can still chant.
जब हरिनाम किया है कौन सा स्थिति है, वो एकदम बिस्तर में सोया हुआ था, क्योंकि मरते समय वो पाप कर्म किया था, काय मन और वाक्य तीनों से उन्होंने पाप किया, इसलिए मरते समय तीन जमदूत आते हैं। अभी उनको तीन जमदूत आए और भयंकर रूप, उनका भयंकर रूप देख कर अजामिल डर गया, गला में काल पास को लगाया। लेकिन उस समय उसने जो हरिनाम लिया, नाम लिया, कह रहे हैं किसका नाम लिया, बोले भगवान का नाम नहीं, बेटा का नाम लिया था। ठाकुर का नाम दिया था, नहीं दिया बेटा का नाम दिया था, तो किसी अवस्था में वो टाटी पेशाब कर रहा था, उसकी टाटी पेशाब निकल रही थी, उसे समझ लिया, बोले लिया गए इसे स्थिर बुद्धि से नहीं चित्कार करके नारायण, जैसे हम सही बैठ करके एकदम स्थिर बुद्धि से ले रहे हैं, वो अस्थिर बुद्धि से लिया था। और कौन बोले अजामिल, अजामिल मतलब बहुत बड़ा पापी, ऐसे कोई पाप नहीं था जो पाप उन्होंने नहीं किया, चिंतन की
So he's describing that how, just like the bhakti itself, the holy nature also of the Lord are supremely independent. He's describing that there is no consideration of time, place, circumstances. The example given is about Ajamil. Ajamil, when he was chanting at the last time of his life, was he in his pure state? Was he chanting for the Lord? He was chanting in absolutely in pure state. He was, all his life he had committed sin through mind, body and speech. And because he had committed sins through these three, so that's why three Yamadutas came to take him. They came to take him away because he had performed sinful activities all his life. And then he began.
There are coming three Yamadutas, no? Coming. Why coming three Yamadutas? Why not coming four, not coming five? Why?
41 speak.
Yeah. Thank you. So Vishwanath is going to tell him, when you're doing some karma, you're doing this karma three ways, body, mind, and speech. So they are coming to three jamdus. But when it's chanting name of the sun, Narayan, but they coming four Vishnu to come. Why four Vishnu to come?
Narayana.
Yeah, you know everything. So he telling this four syllables, you know? Narayana. So they're telling, kar tum marte samay na, jeev ko dekh kar pata chal jata hai, kahan jata hai. Agar wo taati peshab karte hue jayega, samajhna tu seedha narak gaya. Kyunki जब दूध जब आते हैं, जब चाहता पाप कर्म करता है उसको बांध करके मार मार कर ले जाते हैं, लेकिन ये चीज़ को कोई नहीं देखता, वही देखता है मार रहे पीट रहे, मार रहे पीट रहे, टाटी पैसा उसको निकलता है, समझना बहुत दुर्गति है। लेकिन आँखों से अगर गया, मुंह से अगर तालू से ब्रह्म गति थोड़ी अच्छी हो जाती है।
So he was chanting, and how he was chanting, was he in a pure state? No, when he was chanting, he was He saw these Yamadutas, he was so fearful that he passed urine and stool. And Maharaj is describing that, how to understand a person when he is left body, if by watching him how he has left his body, you can understand what will be his destination. So when the person sees Yamadutas, and then they are dragging his subtle body and with a noose, and then he is being whipped by these Yamadutas, this is a very, very fearsome state. And that's why the person, when he is leaving body in this state, in this condition, then he passes urine and stool out of fear. So you can understand the person who is passing urine and stool at the time of leaving body, understand that he has had a very troublesome destination. But suppose somebody leaves his body through eyes or mouth or talu from the forehead, then you understand that he has had a better destination. So he's describing that how he was chanting. Was he chanting in a pure state? When he was chanting, he was passing urine and stool. And was he chanting Lord Narayan's name? No. He was actually calling out for his son. And although he was calling out for his son, was he chanting in a stable mind? No, because by seeing these Yamadutas, he was in such an unstable mind, he was so disturbed. And he was not chanting like how we sit down and chant in a stable mind, peaceful. No, he was shouting. He was shouting and calling for his son. And although he was chanting like this, but still he got the darshan of the Vishnudutas.
I'm telling Aja Mila Api. No, telling who is that person? Are that person? And that person is a very simple activity person. He left his own wife, you know, very young age. He left his own wife, staying one prostitute. And also he have 10 sons. And maintained to them, he doing all nonsense thing he did, you know. Drinking alcohol, eating meat, fish, gambling. But all kind of he doing nonsense thing he did. But even he take the last time, he calling to Narayan, his son, but his son is the Narayana, got to go back. Telling how Lord's name is the pure, how is the Lord's pure name is the very powerful. So then, Vishnudutta they are telling, you know, if four ways in chanting this holy name, then he get benefit. The four way, what is the four way? Somebody telling? Ajamil last time?
Yes, yes, everybody knows. Everybody is, I don't know why that's short.
And this is a Sankirtam. Sankirtam, Parihasyam, Ba. Necessary, you know, you are learning some slogans. You know? Necessary, you are learning the slogans. Sankirtam, Parihasyam, Ba. Stobham, Helenanalva. Vaikuntha Nama Grahanam. Asisa Agaharam Vibhu. जैसे बेटे का नाम नारायण कृष्ण गोविंद राधा गीता सीता नाम रख लिया बारम्बार हम बुलाते उसको संकेत
You are not actually really calling out the Lord's name, but indicating the Lord's name by calling out somebody else. Like you met your son's or daughter's name will be Sita, Mita, Narayan, Ram, etc. And you may call out their names. And by calling these names, because actually they are the names of the Lord, or you do get the result of chanting the holy names.
Yeah, so, you know, sir, Bhakti Kumudu Santa Goswami Maharaj, you know, Bhakti Kumudu Santa is telling story, you know, because the jungle mein paanch chor, pehle jungle hota tha. वो पांच जगह में पांच चोर खड़े हो जाते थे और इशारा करके जो चोरी करते थे अगर पहला नंबर व्यक्ति अगर देखता है कोई व्यक्ति आए ना बोले नारायण नारायण इसका दो अर्थ होता है नारायण जो हर जीव का जो आश्रय है नरकायन और दूसरा तो नर अयन और दूसरा को सावधान भाई एक व्यक्ति आ रहा है सावधान हो जा इसलिए बोले नारायण तो दूसरा व्यक्ति को पता नहीं रहता बोले गोपाल गोपाल कृष्ण गया चाहे थे गोपाल लेकिन गोपाल जो भैया को विशेष करके चराते हैं ज्यादा बुद्धि का कम होता है तो भैया चराते चराते भैया जी से बुद्धि हो जाती है भले लगता है ना थोड़ी सा बेवकूफ भी लगता है ज्यादा बुद्धिमान
सो कुछ बार श्री भक्ति कुमार संत गोस्वामी महाराज शी इज टेलिंग वन पास टाइम दैट हाउ देयर वर फाइव थीव्स एंड दे यूज्ड टू लोकेट देमसेल्फ इन अ फॉरेस्ट एंड दे वुड स्टैंड सम डिस्टेंस अवे फ्रॉम ईच अदर एंड देन वन वुड स्टैंड एट द एंट्रेंस ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट And if you would see somebody approaching, then you would say, Narayan, Narayan, you would call out loud. Narayan means, of course, the Lord's name, one who is the shelter of all the Nar, all the living entities. And also, Narayan means, Narayan means a Nar, a human being is coming. So like this, you would speak that, oh, somebody is coming, you would give an indication that somebody is coming. So it means he's making everybody ready, that yes, be ready, somebody is approaching. And then the other person, he would observe him more closely. And then he would, if you would see that he is a simple person, simple-hearted, simpleton person, then he would shout, Gopal, Gopal. Actually, it is the Lord's name, but also it is the it's indicating that one who is a cowherd boy, one who is a cowherd. So usually those who are taking cows and sheep for grazing, they are simple people. So by this he is observing carefully, closely, and he is saying, Gopal, Gopal looks like not very intelligent, so yes, he can be looted, cheated easily.
Yeah. And when you come to third person, then telling Damodar, Damodar. Bhagavan ko Maya ne baandh diya dam, matlab rassi udar mein. Isse Damodar hai, lekin kehte dam, matlab paisa udar, matlab kamar. Dekhta hai bhaiya isko kamar mein phula phula lag raha hai. Kamar lag raha hai kuch maal hai. Isliye kehte hai Damodar, Damodar isko aise maal paisa hai. Jab chautha ke paas bhi jata tha, bole Vasudev, Vasudev. वासुदेव का बेटा वासुदेव अरे वासुदेव बोलते तो वासुदेव बोले बांस लाओ पिटाई करना शुरू करो अरे पंचाम में बोला हरी हरी है बोले सब कुछ हार दिया
सो लाइक दिस द थर्ड पर्सन वुड स्पीक
दामोदर
दामोदर थर्ड पर्सन देन यू वुड सी देन यू वुड स्पीक दामोदर दामोदर वन वुड स्पीक दामोदर Now, Damodar means the pastime, it is referring to the pastime where the mother Yashoda has tied him Krishna on his udar, on his belly. And also he is indicating Dam also in a Hindi slang it means that Dam means money. So he is saying that Damodar that looks like he has a thick belt on his waist, then we should loot him. And then when he would proceed further, then would, so the other person would say Vasudev, Vasudev. Vasudev means Vasudev means that Vas can also mean a bamboo. So he said, bring a bamboo and we'll hit him and take away all his money.
And Hari Hari.
Hari Hari, and other person will speak Hari Hari, like this, they would speak amongst each other, indicating using the Lord's name. Hari Hari means steal it away, take it away. Because Hari means the one who steals away your senses, and Hari can also mean the one who we can steal away his possessions, etc.
तो उसी समय में एक बजर गिरा, बजर बाद गिरते पांच सौ बाज खत्म हो गई, लेकिन अंतिम समय में भगवान का नाम जो इशारा में ले रहे थे, इशारा करके ले रहे थे, उनकी सब सब संपत्ति हो गई।
So they were chanting like this, they were indicating and chanting the names, using the Lord's names for nefarious activities, stealing, thieving, looting, etc. But at that very moment it was a cloudy moment, and that time a thunderbolt fell and all five of them, and all five of them were burned to ashes. But because they were using the Lord's name, although indicating somebody is something else, but still because they were chanting the Lord's name, all of it attained sadgati, means proper destination.
Yeah, so here Vishwanath Chakravarti technically, if you anyhow, if you take the Lord's name, he must get benefit. So Sri Tulasidas, he gave a nice example, he gave a good example. Can they say, kheti mein jaise gehun lagate, dhan lagate. अब देखते होंगे जो गेहूं लगाते धान ऐसे लेकर कैसे फेंक देते खेत ऐसे फेंक देते, लेकिन वो भले ही उल्टा गिरे मतलब सीधा गिरे, लेकिन पेड़ जब होता है ना वो सीधा होता है। तुलसीदास जी कहते उसी तरह भगवान का नाम, अगर किसी तरह से भी प्रभु का तुम नाम ले लिया किसी तरह से, लेकिन जो फल देगा वो सीधा ही फल देगा, उल्टा फल तो नहीं देगा।
तुलसीदास जी इज कंपेयरिंग द होली नेम्स ऑफ द लॉर्ड टू द farmer's efforts. The farmer goes in the field and he takes the wheat as seeds, and what do they do? He just throws the seeds around, and these seeds are considered to be sown. And when the, although the seeds fall, some of them fall straight, some of them fall crooked, some of them are standing erect, but all of them when they grow, although they fall in whatever direction they've fallen on the ground, but when they grow, all of them are standing erect. All the plants are standing erect. Similarly, he's Tulsi is saying that you may chant the Lord's name in whatever condition, however you may chant, but the result will always be proper, always correct.
Yeah, okay. So, well, Hare Krishna, Hare,
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
इसलिए तुलसीदास जी कहते हैं राम ना सकई नाम गुण गाए, कर भगवान राम भी अपना नाम की महिमा को गा नहीं सकते, भगवान राम भी अपना नाम को सामने फेल हो जाते हैं, अपने नाम को सामने भगवान भी फेल हो जाते हैं, इसलिए कहते हैं राम ना सकई नाम गुण गाए, भगवान
powerful than he himself.
So listen to one story. So where everybody try to note this Al Harigatha. After we went telling some Harigatha, if you do not, then what happens? Then you can tell to somebody. So we are only listening, you know. So then they said to note Al Harigatha. Then after you can speak to somebody. When, okay? We have pain and notebook. You know, so what happened? Only you are listening. After you are forgetting.
Nowadays Maharaj recording.
Huh?
Not writing, nowadays recording.
Yeah. It's recording and writing.
Yeah, recording also doing notes also. Then what happens after you can tell to somebody also. Okay. Hare Krishna. Listen to one story, a good story. How Ram himself defeated this one name, how the power. This is the Ramayana Kaviman story, very good story. But ek samay Kaivarta desh ka ek raja jiska naam Sukam, ek samay Sumer parvat upar satsang ho raha tha, Sukam tha satsang sunne ke liye ja raha tha, jate jate hathat mein Narad beech mein mil gaye, bole Narad ladai bada ke baat mein, bole kahan ja rahe ho, bole Sumer parvat mein bade bade sant log aa rahe hain, satsang hoga, satsang.
So one time he's describing how there was a king by the name of Sukam, and he heard that some Harikatha is being spoken on the top of Sumeru mountain, So in this island,
his name is this country's name is the Kaivart. Kaivart.
His country's name is Kaivart. So this Sukant King, he is traveling and he wants to go and listen to Harikatha, gathering of saintly persons, so he wants to go and listen to Harikatha. Along the way, when he is going, then he meets Narad Muni. And Narad Muni always, he made some very interesting crooked ways. So he meets him, then Narad Muni asks him, where are you going? He says, oh, I'm going to the gathering of saintly persons from somewhere in a mountain where I heard there is going to be some Harikatha being spoken.
सबसे पहले संतों का चरण समझे सबसे पहले ऐसे नहीं गए और सीधा बैठी गई जाए बोले नहीं ये नियम नहीं है इसलिए ब्रह्मा जी कहते हैं कथा सुनने के लिए जब तीन चीज से कथा सुनो बोले काय मन और वाक तीनों से कथा सुनो बोले काय मतलब शरीर बोले शरीर से कैसे कथा करता तो कान से मन से सुनते हैं बोले पहले जाकर के जहाँ कथा होती है सबसे पहले उस जगह को प्रणाम करो क्योंकि जहाँ पर हरि कथा होती है पृथ्वी का सारे तीर्थ होकर बैठे सबसे पहले दूसरे जो कथा बोल रहे हैं बोले तीसरे जो कथा सुन रहे हैं इसे सबसे पहले जाकर उनको प्रणाम करना जिसने संत बैठे हैं सबके सब जाकर सबके पहले उनके सबसे पहले उनका चरण छुना बोले आप लोग तो यही सिखाया सबसे पहले जाकर संतों का चरण छुना बोले ठीक है
So then Narad Muni told him that when you go, it is not that you just go and sit down to start hearing Harikatha. No, this is not the proper way. He said that first of all, when you go, you offer obeisances to the saintly persons and touch their feet.